Okay, so welcome back to the last session for the day after the tea break. So straight going into the action. So what we have here, this is one example which I want to demonstrate where there is no way you can get any solution quicker than using the principle of minimum potential energy. So what we are asked here is something like this. Determine the angle of inclination of each linkage in this figure. Okay, so there are three linkages. W1 L1, W2 L2, W3 L3, these are pinned at these two points, and this is a frictionless surface on which these wheels can roll. And what you are asked to find out is that what is the angle of inclination, or in other words, what is the final configuration for this system when the system ultimately is in equilibrium, and to say if that configuration stable or unstable. And let me give you a hint, you don't need to do a single calculation in order to find out what is the final configuration. Not a single calculation. If you try to do this with equilibrium or principle of virtual work, it will be a huge pain. But with principle of minimum potential energy, okay, just you can just do it. Is the problem clear to everyone? Yeah? Though my one hint is that no equation required. Can you just stare at this problem and like just figure out what is the configuration, okay, final configuration that this system can have? Note one thing, that we want to minimize the potential energy. Okay, so minima is the best. Anytime when you can find a minima, that will be the absolute global minima and the system will be stable. For this to go into minima, what do we need? Each of the rods should be, the center of mass should be as low as possible. So yes, so the L1 and L3 vertical, okay, and the line joining the two ends. Okay, so that will be one minimum configuration straight away. Okay, so this is one of the interesting things you can do, that if L1 plus L2 is greater than L3. Suppose for the time being, assume that L3 is greater than L1. The one L3 is greater than L1 without losing any generality. If you think that, okay, no, L2 is less than L1, just go to the other side and see. Okay, L1 will become L2, L2 will become L3. Okay, so without losing generality, so let's say L3 is greater than L1. Then there are two conditions. One is when L1 plus L2, the two links, is greater than L3, then that configuration shown at the top will be the minimum energy configuration. Any configuration, you try to perturb it from this conformation, whatever way, you will see that the center of mass will only rise. Are you convinced? Okay, so the portion is that without losing generality, we said that L3 is greater than L1. Now, look at this. To minimize the energy, what do we want? We want the center of mass of each rod to go as low as possible. Okay, now take this conformation. What we are saying is that this is as low as possible for one will be when one is completely vertical. Center of mass as low as possible for two, if two is perfectly vertical. Okay, and what is the center of third particle? It will be nothing but L1 plus L2 by 2. Will be the position of the center for third one. So if you make L1 and L2, okay, the centers of the two chains as large as possible, okay, as down as possible, automatically the center for the third chain, okay, for the third link will get as down as possible. So this is possible. But in this case, what you require is that L1 plus L2 should be greater than L3. Now, in case, suppose L1 plus L2 is less than L3, then the second conformation which I have shown, okay, that will be the best conformation. What you will see is that in this case, L1 plus L2 is less than L3. L1 is as low as possible, L2 is as low as possible. And you will see that how do we figure out what is this angle of this third chain, third link? Is just from this point, draw an arc of the circle given by L3 such that it intersects this point, and that will be the final conformation. And the angle is immediately known, that if that angle is nothing but cos theta is equal to L1 plus L2 divided by L3. So there are two possible cases. Without losing generality, L3 is greater than L1. And then afterwards, L1 plus L2 greater than L3 is the top one. And L1 plus L2 less than L3, okay, is the bottom one. And just try perturbing the system from this point, you will see that your energy will always be more than whatever the energy you have now. Because the center of mass will always go up if you depart from this conformation. Make sense?
In the second diagram, the last two terms are W3 into L1 plus L2 by 2.
Yeah, because just note here, assume that for example the center of mass for this, this is L1, this is L2, assume that uniform mass, okay, I am assuming that all the mass is uniform and center of gravity is at the center, okay. So where will the center of this will be? Where will the vertical height? Vertical height is the same as the center of this, which is L1 plus L2 by 2.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, fine. So this is for example one example where you use equilibrium, you use principle of virtual work, there is no way you are going to get this clean an answer. Okay, and of course this is the global minima and this will be a stable configuration. It will be L1 plus L2 by 2. Sorry, it's L1 plus L2 by 2, not the common. My mistake, okay, it's L1 plus L2 by 2 because center of mass will be what, this distance plus the center. So it is L1 plus L2 by 2. Good, sorry for the mistake. Okay, so let's move on. Just note that, okay, because these slides I will give to the person in charge. So just note that if you look at the solution, okay, first of all, I cannot vouch that all solutions are perfectly accurate. I have tried to be as good as possible, but sometimes like clearly I have made mistakes. Okay, so please pardon me for that and be on the guard for some mistakes if you are referring to the slides. Now, let me do this problem actually. Okay, because the gentleman there, he has suggested that we use small angles approximation. So let us do one problem where we actually do the problem with small angle approximation. So what is given to us is a mechanism as follows, okay? So I will discuss this problem and then we will solve two or three more problems in the tutorial, okay? You will solve and at 5:15 I will give you a small quiz, okay? And then we will depart. So let me just discuss this problem briefly. What we are given is this, that we have a mechanism where we have a mass M resting on this two force member which is pinned here at the top and at the bottom. Similarly, it's resting on this another two force member of length B, which is pinned here and pinned here. Now this mechanism, if there were no springs in between, then what happens is that it's an unstable mechanism. If you just give it a little bit of a nudge, then this rectangle, okay, will become a parallelogram and this entire assembly will collapse. So what is being done here is that in order to keep this system in equilibrium, what we have done is that we have taken two springs, we have pre-stressed, we have given a stretch of delta and then put inside this assembly. So spring whose approximate length is this, length little bit of a stretch of delta, put it in. Second spring, take that length, put little bit of delta, put it inside. And now we have this assembly where this internal spring has a little bit, has a pre-stress of delta, pre-stretch of delta, it is not rest. Within this spring, there is a tiny extension of delta. Within this spring, there is a tiny extension of delta. We have taken this assembly, this mass is M, and what we are asked to find out is determine the minimum stiffness K of each spring which will ensure stability of the platform in the position shown. Each spring has a tensile preset deflection of theta. See the question? That this position should be in stable equilibrium and what we want is that given all these dimensions, what should be the stiffness of the spring such that this configuration is actually a stable equilibrium conformation. And now we will use, for example, this small theta approximation because why? We are giving a small perturbation about the position where the theta, which we can take to be the angle of the top links or the vertical links to be equal to 0. What do you think should we do? If we perturb this system, okay, this is a rectangle, let us perturb it by a little bit. Let us make it a parallelogram. So this link, let us perturb it by a small amount such that it makes an angle theta with respect to the vertical. Now if you perturb that link, okay, the other link will also perturb. There is no other choice. So if this angle becomes theta, other angle will also become a small theta. Now what will happen because of that? If we make this link, okay, move by a small angle theta, what will happen to that spring? It will get compressed. Okay, why? Because there is a component of the displacement along that, it will get compressed. What will happen to the second spring? It will get stretched, okay? Can we express that compression and stretch in terms of theta? Very easily, because all the dimensions are given to us. If we say that the vertical, that angle, if this angle, okay, so if I say that this top angle is alpha here, okay, if this top angle is alpha, then what do we know? That if this small rotation is theta, this top angle is alpha, how much is the compression in the spring extra? Draw a perpendicular from here, this is alpha, 90 minus alpha, okay, so this also will be alpha. So B cos alpha into delta theta, or the small perturbation theta, will be how much there will be an extra compression in the spring. You agree? If alpha, I will show it in the solution also, if alpha is the angle on the top, then draw a line from here perpendicular to the spring. If this is alpha, this is 90 minus alpha, so B sine 90 minus alpha or B cos alpha is the perpendicular distance. So B sine alpha, sorry, B cos alpha into theta will be the compression in that, in this spring. And correspondingly, B cos alpha into theta for small theta will be the extra extension in this spring. Will you agree with me? Okay, fine. Now, what is the potential energy contribution for a small theta for the top mass? If I take base, okay, as my datum, what is the potential energy of the top mass as a function of this theta? The B cos theta? If what is theta? The way I am defining theta is B rotates by small angle theta, so theta is the new angle with respect to vertical. So B cos theta. No, vertical, vertical. Vertical height. Cos theta, B cos theta. Okay, B cos theta. Then you are putting, we have to then take the datum, top level as a datum, then it will be minus mg B1 minus cos theta, which will come out to be the same, plus some additional constant. Everybody agrees, or there is some dissent, or there's somebody doesn't agree? Okay, it is not by intimidation. Okay, if you don't agree, just we will discuss this. So just look here. This angle is theta. This is this vertical arm. It was position was here. What is this distance? B cos theta. And B cos theta, as we had discussed earlier, for small theta, can also be rewritten as 1 minus theta square by 2. Okay, because we want to do everything without cos and sines, we can say that B cos theta can be written as 1 minus theta square by 2. Does everybody agree that for small theta, cos theta can be written as 1 minus theta square by 2? Yes? Okay, so we'll go by consensus. Now what do we do? V gravity is what? Mg B cos theta. Here I have used cos theta, but I say that even if you replace this cos theta by 1 minus theta square by 2, it still will be fine. Only thing what we want to know is, for stability purposes, this V should at least be quadratic. Okay, at least be quadratic. Now what is the extension in this spring? Initial extension was delta. This spring got compressed. So what is the final extension? Delta minus B theta cos alpha. You agree with me? What is the extension of this spring? Delta plus B theta cos alpha. So my total potential energy will be mgb cos theta plus half k delta minus B theta cos alpha square plus half k theta minus B theta cos alpha square. Just expand it out. What you will see is that your potential energy just looks like this. Now you take the derivative dv by d theta. You will see that at theta equal to 0, this indeed is 0, which means that theta equal to 0, as expected, was an equilibrium position. And d2v by d theta square will just come out to be 2k b square cos square alpha minus mgb, just simple algebra. And you want, for stability purposes, that this should be greater than 0. That will immediately tell you that minimum spring constant will be mg 2b cos square alpha. And you will realize that what is cos square alpha? What is cos alpha? Cos alpha is nothing but L divided by L square plus B square. You agree with me? Cos alpha will be L divided by square root of L square plus B square. So cos square alpha will be L square divided by L square plus B square. Just put in all the values and you will see that the minimum stiffness will be mg by 2b, 1 minus B square by L square. And if your stiffness is at least this much, the assembly, okay, or stiffness should be more than this, strictly speaking, because exactly at that stiffness what happens, we don't know. But if your stiffness is more than that, then your assembly will be in stable equilibrium. Is the problem clear? Okay, any doubt? Any doubt? So can we move on to solve some 3 tutorial problems and then go on with the quiz?